Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from GuyNQ. There were some recent updates to the data storytelling capabilities with PowerPoint, and I just have to do a video on it. So enough of all this talking. Yes, enough of all this talking. You know I like to do a GuyNQ. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So I found this report that I want to use in the next meeting that we're having over at GuyNQ to talk about all of our sales and amount of freight and where we're selling stuff. So I want to use this in a PowerPoint. It's really easy to do it. If you click the share button, you see an option right here for PowerPoint. I'm just going to click that to open in PowerPoint. Right? Watch this. It's going to open up already embedded in my PowerPoint slide. This is great. There's an instruction slide if you want to know how to get that add-in into PowerPoint. Okay, we don't need that. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little emphasis around this. I'm going to do a little formatting of this particular element to kind of emphasize that it's from Power BI or something like that. So you can see there's a little format, a little styles option right here. So I can add an outline. And then what I can do is I can change the color of that outline. So let's get a little GuyNQ blue in there, and we'll change the width of it. It's just a nice little accent to kind of make it stand apart from the other elements on the page, right? But that's not all they did. Now I want to have a little narrative that explains everything in this visual. So what I would normally do is go insert text box, start typing. You don't have to do that. Go to the little Power BI icon, click the up arrow, and look at their data insights. I'm going to enrich this slide with insights from Power BI. So go ahead and click it. It's going to generate my insights. And then I'm going to say, just go ahead and paste it on the slide. So it takes it right there for me. And it adds that little description of this to the slide for me. Are you kidding me? I don't have to type anything. It's just a little AI maybe? I don't know. Okay. The next thing, I was looking at a report and I want an individual element from that report to kind of round out my slide. Well, you couldn't do that before, but now you can. Let me show you. I'm over here in Power BI and I have access to the workspace so I can get the entire report. But if you didn't want the entire report inside of the workspace, you can just click the little ellipsis right here and you can see where it says share link to visual. I didn't have access to the workspace. I had access to an organizational app. Can I get an individual visual from an organizational app? Let's check it out. So I'm over in my app and here's a chart that's doing annual sales comparison. I wanted to add that to my report. So if you click the ellipsis, same place, choose share, I'm going to say link to this visual. Go ahead and copy it. Boom. Get that copied on my clipboard. Head back to PowerPoint. Go to insert. There's my Power BI add-in. I'm going to go ahead and click it. Paste this in there, choose insert, and individual visual will now be embedded directly inside of my PowerPoint. And so I'm gonna just grab this and move this over a little bit. I can generate some insights from it. I can format it. I can do all types of things with it. So many capabilities are coming to this data storytelling with PowerPoint. I'd love to know if you're using it. If you have any questions, comments, any feedback, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to know more about how to get started with doing the data storytelling with PowerPoint, go check out that video that's flying over my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.